Last class I had started with pronouns, right? And I had discussed how many kinds of pronouns are there. So there are how many kinds? There are 10 kinds of pronouns, right? Personal, demonstrative, interrogative, distributive, emphasizing, indefinite, possessive, reflexive, relative, and reciprocal pronouns. So, and I had discussed or and I said about possessive adjectives also, isn't it? So, on page 26, there is a table where it is written personal pronouns, possessive pronouns, possessive adjectives. Alright, so you can go through the table and I will be read and I have sent you the PDF also before the class started. So, you can go through it, and as well as you have to do that exercise on page 27 and 28. Exercise A on page 28. Alright, then the next exercise, you will do it for the next class. So today I'm going to tell you about possessive adjectives as well as prepositional phrase. Alright, so read this sentences to show the difference between possessive adjectives and possessive pronouns. So that is my pen is possessive adjective. That pen is mine is possessive pronoun. Mine. Alright? It belongs to me. This is our cartoon of books. So that is possessive adjective. This cartoon of books is ours. So that is possessive pronouns. So ours, mine, theirs, hers, those are all possessive pronouns. Yours, his, theirs, hers, mine, those belong to possessive pronouns, and possessive adjectives are my, his, a, her, its, are, your, there. Alright, so those are possessive adjectives. So there is prepositional phrases also. Phrase, what is a phrase? It's a group of words, isn't it? Like according to. So if you frame a sentence with along with, I went for a party along with my friends. So that along with is a prepositional phrase. Possessive pronouns can be used in prepositional phrases beginning with of. Alright, to qualify a noun group. So you can use prepositional phrases also in possessive pronouns. Like I have borrowed a jacket of his for a few hours. So this means the same as I have borrowed his jacket for a few hours. So you can have a look at the box which is highlighted in yellow, and those are prepositional phrases. On behalf of, right, in order to, in spite of, so in spite of, it's a prepositional phrase. So when you make a sentence, you can write, in spite of working hard, my sister failed in the examination. So what did I do? I used that prepositional phrase into a sentence. Alright? So in that way, you can use those prepositional phrases into sentences. So today I will tell you about demonstrative pronoun and interrogative pronoun. What is demonstrative pronoun? Demonstrative is what it demonstrates. Alright, it tells you something about, like this, that, those, demonstrative pronoun. So here it's there, pronouns such as this and that, which are used to refer to objects and people are called demonstrative pronoun. So this is my tumbler. This is my tumbler. T-U-M-B-L-E-R. Okay. So that
is yours.
So which one is demonstrative pronoun here? This and that. All right, this is my tumbler, that is yours. That means you are demonstrating, or you're talking about the tumbler or water bottle which is yours. All right, these are my, so another one is these are my earrings. Those are of someone else's. Those are someone else's. So, which one is the demonstrative pronoun here? These and those. So, right, that and this, these and those, this and that is singular. So these and those are plural. So the words this and that in the first sentence are pronouns and they are used for singular noun. This is my tumbler. So you're talking about one. All right. So these are my earrings. These are what? More than one. So that is plural. So it is. So possessive pronouns are used in singular as well as in plural. The pronouns these and those similarly are used to point out objects and people. So you can also use these and those for objects and also for people. So they are used for plural nouns. All right. So now the next one is interrogative pronoun. So today I will do demonstrative and interrogative, okay? So in the next class I will be doing the other one, which is distributive and reflexive. We'll do two at a time, right? Because it takes a lot of time to understand. So today I said I've done demonstrative, now interrogative pronoun. So what do you mean by interrogative? Interrogative means when you ask questions, isn't it? So which of these handkerchief is yours? Whom did you yell at? What is the reason for this chaos? So for example, which, whom, what, are, what? These are interrogative. You're asking questions, isn't it? Like, which of these handkerchiefs is yours? Whom did you yell at? What is the reason for this chaos? So these are interrogative pronouns, which, because you're asking some questions. So these words are interrogative pronouns because they help ask questions. So when framing questions, who or whom is used for a person or a group of people. So when you frame questions, you have to remember that when you're using or when you're asking for a person or a group of people, you have to use who and or whom. All right, when you're asking about, when is used for a person or a group of people, what is used for things? Now, what you have to use for things, all right, and which is used for a person or an object. So, which you have to use for a person or an object, and what is used for things? What is inside your bag? What is on the table? All right. Whom did you meet on the way? So all those are questions when you ask somebody. So these are interrogative pronouns. So as I told you that I will do only demonstrative and interrogative pronouns today, and I've sent you the PDF. So please do that exercise on page 27. So you have to use only personal pronouns in exercise one. Right, and one pronoun can be used more than once. You can repeat the pronoun in that sentence. For example, number one, my sister Anu loves food. This burger is for her. Now you can't write hers, right? So that is personal pronoun. So you have to write her. The students loved the documentary on animals. The documentary is for them. Okay, so Manjunath has many picture postcards. She collects it, or it could be he collects it. So similarly, the musicians have shot a new video. They are releasing it next week. So in that way, please do exercise 1 on page 27, number 1 to 10, and you have to do exercise A, fill in the blanks with interrogative pronouns. So you just have to use what, which, whom, what, alright? So that which you use in a sentence to frame sentences or questions. Number one, what was the journey like? You can't write which was the journey like or whom was the journey like, right? So read the sentence and use the appropriate word, like which, what, whom. Okay, on page 28, exercise A, please do 1 to 10. So number two will be Dash knows what will happen next. What, who knows what will happen next? You can't write which will happen, what will happen. Okay, so read the sentence, think and write this interrogative pronouns. You have to use who, whom, what, which. You can't use any other pronouns in question number 2 or exercise A on page 28. Please go through it again, alright? And if you have any queries, you can WhatsApp me in my number. And in the next class, I will do the remaining pronouns, reflexive, distributive, and relative pronoun. So till then, take care and be safe. Thank you.